now, the Crypt Keeper of Creepy, the provocative Prince of the Tweens, the Nightmare from Neptune. It's Zabujard!
Hey guys, you guys are my big dogs. You guys are my big dogs. Jer here. Hope you guys don't mind being called a big dog. I'm going to the dentist again today. I'm not thrilled about it. I went 2 weeks ago for 2 hours. It was 2 hours long. And I have ten cavities. And they filled five, and now today they have to fill the other five, so I do not want to go. But also, I was kind of angry because I got a parking ticket this morning. I don't know how much it is, I haven't looked at it yet, but it's probably anywhere from $28 to $60 or something. Because my parents don't like me to park in the driveway. And so when I park on the street, if I don't move it the right way, then I get a ticket. This has happened multiple times. And I know I tell you guys how much I hate money, but I still get really mad when I get parking tickets, I'm not gonna lie. Because I spent like 10 hours this week on a commission for someone. And now half of the money's gone to a parking ticket probably, so... I just hate this world, and I'm ready to leave as soon as possible, go to heaven, and not even think about you or anyone from this world ever again, because I'm sorry, but this world is shit, and you have to admit that it's shit, and you should want to get out of here too. No offense to you or anyone. I mean, I'm sure we can talk in heaven if you want to talk, but I want to get out of here. I just desperately want to get out of here. They got fucking drag queens teaching kids how to read and write. What's going on? Anybody asking here what's going on? What's going on? Remember that old 70s song, What's Going On, or whatever? I have two things I want to go over, and I forget things really easily and really quickly, so I'm going to try to remember these two things. The first thing I want to go over is a story, and the second thing is the Chinese, situation. So number one, let's go into the story. This is why. Have you guys noticed each year that goes by, I sound more and more like Alex Jones, and I haven't even watched Alex Jones in like 13 years since high school. When he used to say really funny things, like they're turning the freaking frogs gay, which is true. Some people call them froggets. Some people call them fog frogs. And they're turning the frickin' frogs gay. That's the best thing he's ever said. He's a funny guy. That's the funniest thing. And that's my favorite line that he's ever said. They're turning the frickin' frogs gay. I love that story. You guys have to realize when shit hits the fan. Oh, by the way, my judge on my disability made a decision, but he hasn't told me the decision yet. So any day now, any second, I should be getting that letter with the judge's decision, because it's been almost 3 months, and it should not take 3 months. It should take 1 to 2 months. About neat bucks. Wish me luck, I guess. You guys have to realize when shit hits the fan, right, they're gonna ban GUNSs. They're gonna ban... homeschooling. They're gonna ban.
Alright, hold on! Come on, what?
Jesus Christ. Okay. They're gonna ban GUNSs, so get one while you can. They're gonna ban, they're gonna ban everything. You're not gonna be able to go outside of your house again like the lockdown. They're going to say, if you want food, we'll deliver it to you. If you want money, we'll deliver it to you. If you want, prostitutes, we'll deliver it to you. I don't know. They're going to lock everyone inside their house again forever. Except it'll be a very tiny apartment. Not a house. No going outside. Cameras all over your apartment watching your every fart. Your every fart. Lock you down completely. They want everyone locked up in their house just like they did in lockdown. Why do you think they did that? Because they want everyone locked up. They want nobody having freedom. Complete control over you and your farts and your balls. Everything you think, everything you say. That's why the neural brain Elon Musk brain chips are coming out. You gotta put it in your fucking brain. That's probably the marks. They're gonna control your thoughts. If you think about farting, they're gonna change your mind. And you say, actually, I'm gonna hold that fart in. I'm not gonna fart. They're gonna change and lock your brain around. They're gonna control you like a gay little sock puppet. N-word, blah, blah, blah. F-A-G word, blah, 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 blah. They're gonna control your cock and your balls and your fart and your ass and your vagina and your eyes and your brain and your nose and your mouth. They're gonna feed you crickets and bugs every day. No more meat. They're gonna ban meat. They're gonna ban fruits and vegetables. Only crickets for the cricket boy. They're gonna legally change your name to Faggy Little Cricket Boy. They're gonna legally change your name to Crabby Little Faggy Little Cricket Little Baby Back Bitch Cricket Boy. That's your new name. So from now on in the comments, everyone in the comments who watches these videos, change your YouTube screen name to Cricket Boy, because that's what they're going to try to change your name to. When you write a comment in the comments, start off by saying, first off, my name really is Cricket Boy. And secondly, here's my comment. You know, structure your comments that way, because they are going to turn you into crickets. And they're going to feed you crickets. And they're going to enslave everyone, because the devil is like, that's like why slavery even existed, right? Because the devil wants to make all of us his slaves, you know? That's just how it is. You know, in a couple months or a year, when Chinese soldiers, the SS, which is short for slant soldiers, come knocking at your door, and they say, Feng Shui Kong Kang Kang Kong, which is Chinese for come outside, we're gonna cut your head off. You have to be prepared. First off, you should try to meet a Chinese person and be friends with them. Because then when the Chinese soldiers come to your door in a few months and say, Feng Shui, Qing Chang Kwa, then you'll say, oh, do you know Qing Fong? And they'll say, yeah, we know Qing Fong. He's a good boy. And then you can say, well, he's my friend. And they say, okay, we won't cut off your head because you friend with Qing Fong. And they'll go to the next door to your neighbors and they'll chop off their heads. So that's coming. They are crossing the border right now, tons of Chinese soldiers and stuff, probably. Maybe. I don't know. I'm guessing that's what's going to happen. And as soon as they get the signal, bang, they're going to come to your door and cut your head off. What happened 2 or 3 weeks ago? 3 random businesses in Washington got kabanged by explosives, all within 15 minutes. Now, that's not a Zoomer doing that. That's not a kid doing that. That's not a gay person doing that. That's not a gay frog doing that. That's a professional hit. That's a professional hit when 3 businesses get kabloomed in 15 minutes 3 weeks ago in Washington, D.C. That's a professional Chinese soldier, probably. That's a professional kablooer, kabanger. I don't want to think he has to say the words on here because he teaches fucking gay shit. And you're going to see more of that. You're going to see more kablooies and kabangies going off in a professional fashion like you did 22 years ago with the controlled demolition of 2 big buildings. Well, actually 3 or 4 in New York. Anyways, I want to tell... I'm trying to psych you guys up. If I get $8, you think it's going to matter? When they say, actually, if you want $8, you actually need 5 boosters. Sorry, they'll just take it away. Take away my $8. They say, actually, you need 5 boosters and you need the neural musk brain implant in your brain. And I'm going to say, I'm not taking all that shit. And I say, okay, then we're taking your $8 away and they'll take it away. So don't depend on the government. Don't depend on anything except your relationship with yourself, people in your community. Hopefully you can join a group of Malay. Create a Malay, join a Malay, the people, your neighbors around you, create a group of strong young men who love bangs and They're like a Shah, a Malay Shah. And have a good relationship with God and Jesus and pray all the time. Pray to escape the things that are coming, the Bible says, because things are coming and they're not going to be good things. That's why it says to do that. And believe, I don't know, like believe in yourself, believe in others. Because people are going to go, I mean, I'm already going crazy. But like, imagine when they fucking take away, the energy grid goes off, boom, no more electricity. No more staring at your phone for 18 hours a day. No more 6 meals a day when they take away all the food and give you crickets. Look at how fat everyone is. Right now, the America is the story of Hansel and Gretel. Yes! I'm up. What's up? I took a short one, yeah. Okay. Okay.
I don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay. Do you understand that? Turn the friggin' frogs gay. Serious crap, gay. Frogs, friggin' frogs. It's not funny. I'm gonna say it real slow for you. Gay. Frogs.
Like Hansel and Gretel. They've fattened everyone up. Soon they're gonna take the food away. Everyone's going to starve. People are gonna go fucking crazy when they can't have KFC 4 times a day when that's what they're used to. They're gonna go crazy when they can't play Candy Crush for 18 hours a day like they usually do. They're gonna go fucking crazy when they can't get on TikTok or Twitter or have clean water. I don't know. Have all these things that they are used to. That we've been spoiled into having. When all those things get taken away from you and me and everyone around you, what do you think is going to happen? Think about this. Logically, think. I'm just trying to prepare you guys. I'm like a preppy boy now. I'm like a real preppy boy. I'm a doomer and I'm a preppy boy now. I've embraced it. You know, I'm like embracing it or something. And I still don't have a bang, a G-U-N. I really need to get one because I'm fucked. I got a slingshot. What do you think a slingshot's gonna do to a soldier? Am I gonna sling my cum at him? You know, I need a G-U-N. I can't be using a cum covered slingshot when the end times come. Are you kidding me? Crazy, I need to get one, but it takes forever in California. It takes at least an hour, plus another few weeks. It really sucks here. Anyway, last story, and then I'm gonna go. This is a great story to end on because it's a really funny, cute story. It's family friendly for the whole family. You guys are gonna love this story. When I was in junior high, 7th grade, 17 or so years ago, or 18 or whatever, I had this Scottish friend in PE class named Stuart Feeney, and he'd always pick on this gay kid in our class named Timmy Finley. Hopefully both of them are still alive, I guess. And Timmy would, this was 18 years ago, right? And this kid was coming to school with full-on makeup as a boy, right? He was pushing the boundaries back then, even back then, right? Because it wasn't like it is now where every Zoomer comes to school with a cake face full of fucking makeup. and their ass is fucking covered in makeup and shit and stuff, you know? So he's got the mascara on, he's got the lipstick, everything, right? As gay as you can be, right? And one day, and Timmy would always pick on him, calling him gay and stuff, right? Which I hated that. I hated how Timmy would always pick on this poor kid. And so don't worry, this has a great ending, guys. This has a great ending. And I like Stuart. He's a great guy. He's so funny. The Scottish are so funny. He told me he would get drunk all the time, and we were only 12 or 13. He was telling me he's getting drunk. I didn't start getting drunk till I was like 16. This guy's got balls on him. He says all the time in Scotland, you can drink at 12 and 13, so he'd always drink over there. Which is crazy to me. As an American, I've never been to Europe, ever. I kind of want to go one time before and check it out sometime. Write in the comments if you want me to come live with you in Europe. That'd be crazy. I'd do it. I'm not a fag. I'm not a frog, I meant to say. I'm not a gay little frog. So anyways, one day Timmy is crying his eyes out. He's crying, he's bawling as much as possible. He's crying, you know. He's a mess. His mascara is going down his face. His makeup's a mess. It's ruined. And Stuart goes over to Timmy and he says, Timmy, why are you crying, you fucking faggot? Just as lovely as Stuart could in his Scottish accent. Which I don't support him saying that. But I love that he said that and that he had such a funny accent. I walk over with him. He said, come on, we have to go over here and talk to this kid. Timmy, why are you crying, you fucking faggot? And Timmy said, my best friend died. I can't do it. He sounds like a gay guy. My best friend died. And Stuart's like, oh shit. How'd he fucking die? And Timmy says, he was lifting a barbell over his head in the gym, and he dropped the barbell and it landed on his neck and chest, and he suffocated and he killed him. He's crying as he's telling us his best friend died because he dropped the barbell on his neck and it killed him somehow. Mister said, stop crying, you fucking faggot. And then we walked. We walked away. I mean, and there's normie fucking girls standing around us, and they're just disgusted and angry about how unbelievably alpha and based Stuart is. You know, but he's a real gem, that guy. I mean, I. When you meet someone that based, I'm gonna remember that story forever, and I hope you are too. It's an incredible story. And I've met you guys, and you guys are based, so I'm gonna remember you guys too, don't worry. I hope you guys remember me too. Yeah, I was watching this podcast yesterday, these guys. They were going over kind of edgy culture that kind of disappeared from society, you know, 10 years ago or so. And they were saying things like, you know, I just can't do the goody two-shoes role like all these other people can. You know, I love saying the N-word too much. I can't just, like, pretend to be a goody two-shoes like everyone else can. And I'm thinking in my head, yeah, you know what? I can't either. Because I love saying the N-word like hundreds of times per day, at least. In my head. Or out loud, I don't care. But it's just a fun word. And there's other words I say that aren't very nice words either. As you guys have noticed in the podcast, you know, they get taken down if I say too many naughty words. So I can never be the goody two-shoes role either because one, I think my brain's a little skitzy or whatever. Two, I have bad habits that are surrounding cursing. 3, I was on 4chan when I was 17 and I soaked up all the edginess as much as possible and I still have a bunch left over in me. And 4, I just can't fake being a great two-shoes very well, unless maybe I'm at church or something. I think maybe I do okay there. And 5, I just think I like freedom of speech too much. I don't know if I mentioned that. And 6, I just think it's kind of gay to be a goody two-shoes if it's not really how you operate. Or if that's not like 7, I'm not trying to make excuses for sinning through cursing or things like that or anger. But, it's just, yeah, it's, I never was that type of to limit myself on, the edginess of thoughts and ideas and words and anything like that. I went to the boundary line. I pushed the boundaries of words, ideas, jokes, thoughts, humor, everything. I've pushed the boundary to in my life. And so when you're living on the edge boundary, then you're far away from the safe middle ground of social norms and social safeties and things like that. So yeah, that's it. That's yeah. Like I said, guys, just hope you guys are doing well. Maybe think about preparing and stuff in any way you can, whatever that means to you. Because when shit hits the fan, are you going to man up, or are you going to say, man, well, I hope the Chinese soldiers who come to the door don't misgender me. I hope they don't call me a boy when I'm actually a they-them pronoun. Or are you going to be ready with a fucking baseball bat to hit their fucking head, hit them in the dick, in the asshole. Tell them to get off your lawn. It's up to you. You choose which one you want to be. Do you want to bend over your asshole and have them stick a 10th booster inside your left butt cheek? And go, oh, that's my 10th booster in my ass. Or are you going to grab a baseball bat and you say, no, I'm not going to take another booster. I'm not going to take a mark. You're not coming into my house. You're not taking my food away. You're not giving me crickets. Suck my dick. And hit them in the balls with a baseball bat. I mean, you choose which one you want to be. Or you be the wimpy zoomer and say, oh, I'm on HRT right now. My cock is pretty much the size of a centimeter, like little tiny little garden worm. And I hope that they don't misgender me in the prison that they're going to send me to. And I hope they give me a big plate of crickets today, because that's what we're having in the prison cafeteria, is crickets again. Yum. I love yummy crickets in my ass. And I can have as many gender names in prison as I want, which is incredible. And they give every prison inmate an iPad. And the apps on the iPad are Metaverse and Facebook. And they let us play Candy Crush and Angry Birds during recess time in the prison that they sent me to at the FEMA camp. And things are okay. Anyways, talk is cheap. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna say if they come knocking at my door? I mean, am I gonna go out in a blaze of glory, or am I gonna fucking run out the back door as fast as I can into the woods? You pick which one you do, guys. You pick. The Bible says to get a really big bag, because during the tribulation, a lot of us, or you, or me, are going to possibly be moved from our homes due to armies, disasters, fires, everything. The Bible says to get a big bag and fill it with a lot of crap, because you're going to be a traveler in the end times, possibly. And you're going to need a big bag to carry on your back with all your stuff. Your food, your water, your shoes, whatever. Maybe we're going to be bag traveler. Maybe we're going to be bag boys. Think about it. That's all I'm going to say. I'm just nervous about the dentist again. And I got a parking ticket. Not happy about that. Demons are all around you every single day, working to destroy you, working to make you grumpy and sad. Think about that. That parking ticket cocksucker. That's a demon. Trust me. People who have a career as a parking ticket guy, I'm sure they're evil, cocksucking losers because I got a parking ticket. And that's a demon today for me. He was a demon to me today because he made me grumpy. Is he actually a demon? I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe he's just doing his job, but I'm not happy about it. Not happy about ticket enforcers when I'm parked in front of my house. Have the street cleaner go around my car, okay? I'm parked in front of my house. You're gonna give me a ticket? Suck my asshole dick, fucking ticket people. Sorry, guys. I'm just grumpy about a lot of shit this morning. I'm so grumpy about shit. And I prayed about it. I prayed to stop being so fucking grumpy about shit this morning, but I'm still a little grumpy. Anyway, God bless you and your family, and keep your chin up, keep your head up. Don't do yoga. It's Indian evil possession magic. You know, do whatever, and see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye. Thanks for coming by. Bye-bye.
Now it's time to have a snuggle with my very best friend in the whole wide world. You. Well, I'm glad you could come over. See you soon. Bye.
The clown jumped over the moon.